So just two more, two more bits to do. Hi there, and welcome back. I've just had a little break from doing this model. Starting to get on my nerves a bit, but hey ho, we will persevere. Fit all the doors and bonnet, just got to do the glass. You have to be so careful, as it is with mirrors, door mirrors. This model only came with a right-hand door mirror bit model when I do the RS2000. That will be something to stay tuned for. That will be a labor of love, but I'm hoping it's gonna be worth it, and I'm hoping you guys are gonna stick with me, because that does take a lot of time. But the end result will be worth it when you see it. If you look at what this was before and what it's gonna be, hopefully you'll be as pleased as me, or as surprised as me, how it's turned out. So yeah, so onwards and upwards. So what I'm gonna do now is just, I basically didn't show you how these wheels were fitted. What I've done, I've kept the axle, and I've grinded it back so it's flat, and therefore allowing me to fit a screw directly through through the aluminium wheel straight into the axles, and the same with the hubs at the front. So you flatten it down. I'll show you one previous. So with the axles, oh, it's easier to show you down there. With the axles, you grind that back, then you're able to fit the aluminium wheels directly onto the axle. So grind it back, but I tend to leave the discs that come with this car and grind them both back, and they sort of melt into each other, and then you can drill a new hole for the wheels to be fitted on, and that's how I generally fit my wheels, so they do rotate on the model. They won't run freely, but they will rotate, which means you can set them up when you're taking photos. You can position the wheels how you want. I tend to put a little camber on them as well, so they fit into the arches. And again, if you have the, if you try and keep the original axles as much of it as possible, you can then grind it down to the cambers that you want, getting the stance right on it. I tend to do it by eye now, because I've been doing it such a long time. That's how the wheels are fitted. So I'm just going to put this model back together now. So these are all further projects that I will do. They're all awaiting finishing. Triumph Stag needs a new windscreen, so I need to get a windscreen for that. Autoart Ford Cortina GT Mark 1. I've got that all stripped down. I'm actually gonna, I haven't decided on a colour, but I'm gonna do a Mark 1 Ford Cortina. That was a racing one, but I'm hoping to change that up. It's just choosing the colour for it. I'm gonna do these little bits for you, and I'm just gonna come back in a little while. This is for doing my detailing. I tend to use this. I know it looks a bit stupid, but it's pretty good. I tend to use it, basically my eyesight's going. So when I'm up close and personal on a model, I have that pointing direct, and it just gives me that little extra bit of light so I can see what I'm doing. And I always find you either get shadows when you're doing little bits and pieces, your hand casts a shadow and you can't see. So I tend to, as I say, I tend to have that little bit of light, and just to give me an extra brightness where I'm working, so I can see precisely what I'm doing. No guessing involved. Right, I better take this off now. Right, model's all put back together, almost. Just gotta glue in some bits. You can see I've fitted the wheels. Wheels are all fitted. Glass is all in. Just got to glue in the wiper blade, front spoiler, rear lenses. I won't do the front grille as yet because I'm waiting on some spotlights, or if I can get them, because I most probably will have to cut the grille out in order to fit spotlights. So I won't do the grill. The grill's going to be the last thing I actually glue in. So yes, now let's get to it. I need my lights. Let's go. Glue time. Dabba dabba doozy, dab away.
Scalpel blade obviously gets clogged up with glue and it does build up. Normally I have a little pair of pliers and I can just squeeze together and get the glue off if I need to be more precise. Yeah, that will do. I will not put this near my model because I'm likely to, knowing my luck, I will drop it on the model and it will damage the model. Right, let's do the bumpers. No, let's do the lights. I'm just gonna, there is a slight angle on these, so you could easily put the glue on and put them in the wrong place. So once you do that, that's it, you're finished. Size them up. I'd recommend you size them up, make sure they fit in the correct place before you even attempt to glue them in.
To hold it in place. Right, that's number two. Bumper. This is the boring bit. It's all looking very, 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 very nice. Radiator in. Oh. Whew. Let's hope that's straight, because if it isn't, I'm in big trouble. Oh, cold. Guess what? Mirror I've got is for a left-hand drive. And of course, this is a right-hand drive and I haven't got a mirror. This is how it always goes. So I have nicked them off my Mark II Escort. I think that's all the glue in for now, so I need to get back to normal right now. Okay, I'm back. What I'm gonna do, shoot of this model outside rather than in this studio, just a little bit under artificial light. It might look better. It might look better out in the daylight, so that's what I'm going to do for the reveal on the last show of this build. That's the final spotlight. So it doesn't quite finish the model without the spotlights. I've got the rear spoiler to glue on. Mind you, I might as well just glue in the front spoiler. So I'm just going to glue in the front spoiler. Might as well do that now, because there's no, I won't do, I'm not sure if I'll do the rear spoiler, but front spoiler does look good. You can see in the photo, looks good. Right, we're almost there. Gosh, my bum hurts sitting on this damn seat. I'd stand up, but my head would hit the ceiling, so it was made for very small people back in the 18th century. Yeah, 18th century, very small people then, so very low ceilings. Just quickly show you, there you go, that looks good, doesn't it? That grill, I'll present you, we'll show you that the great reveal. Well, it's not going to be a great reveal, and that's going to be the weekend. What do you think with the color coding wheels? And it looks brilliant because I've set it a few inches lower and it looks really good with the revolutionary wheels. But that's with color coded. I think that looks really good. You can see the roll cage inside as well. So just two more bits to do. Mirrors and spotlights. There, the things. That's me. Rear spoiler. I could glue that in, but I'm not gonna. I just don't fancy doing that yet. I'm gonna leave that rear spoiler to last. What it hasn't got is the lugs. It's gonna be a little bit tricky. Again, a resin part, so it's not original. So it's a resin part I purchased a while ago. I'm just gonna have to bite the bullet and just glue it on. And this is always a bit concerning because there's no lugs and there's no holes and you're just relying on the glue, the spoiler on the glue on the paintwork for it to keep in that position. Yeah, so it's a bit tricky, It's not one I don't want to do until the end. So, and that will be part of the reveal. I suppose when the spoiler's on, you'll see how that looks. Let's just turn that round. You will see when that spoiler's on, that makes the world of difference in terms of what this car will look like at the very end. So that's the end of part 3.5. The next video will be the final video. That's with the decals. Okay, thanks again for watching and stay tuned. We're almost there. Ouch. Gosh, my bum hurts sitting on this damn seat.